right, thank you all very much. We are the Whitworth Jazz Ensemble 2. Glad you could join us for this combined concert here. We're going to hear from concert band a little later on in the show. Be sure to stick around after intermission. That was a swing era classic right there. Any Woody Herman fans in the crowd tonight? Any Woody Herman, great big band leader, swing era musician. That was one of his signature tunes entitled Woodchopper's Ball, featured a handful of different soloists. And we're going to move on and feature another soloist, senior in the band. This is Jace on the trumpet. We're going to feature him on this Jeff Jarvis composition. And we're going to hear a little bit from, we have piano solo, Courtney Haupt, and Caleb McGever on guitar. I think that's it. Yes. So, Bradley's Time. That's Jade Spiney. All right, so we're going to move on, change up the pace considerably here now. And we're going to play a unique composition by Pat Metheny. And this arrangement comes from the pen of Bob Kernow. Bob Kernow is a great big band leader. He arranged and was associated with the Kenton Band, another reference to the swing era. And also a local gem, a diamond in the rough here in the Inland Northwest. He makes his home in the area. I've had the privilege to play in his band for the last several years. Great, great man. Had a tremendous career and still running a big band to this day. We just did a little recording session back in September. He's still pumping out new charts and new music. And this is a lovely composition. We're going to feature one of our other pianists. This is Caitlin Shaw, and she's going to play a nice intro, outro on this very rubato, very coloristic kind of piece. It's entitled In Her Family, Caitlin Shaw. for something completely different from that. We're going to transition to a great New Orleans-style classic here. This is entitled Basin Street Blues in traditional kind of horn line style. We're going to feature our brass players, Annika on trombone. We hear a little bit from Joey on trumpet, and a few moments from Mitchell here on the drums, too. He's playing a nice trad Nola beat for us on this one. This is titled Basin Street Blues. Okay, we've got one more selection for you before the concert band will take the stage after intermission. Thanks again for all those of you attending, both here in person, those of you checking out the live stream online at this moment. So, in the spirit of the theme of this concert a little bit, talking about glory, we're going to play this classic traditional hymn, but set in a very different modern jazz kind of a way. This is To God Be the Glory. It's done in a faster samba montuno style. We'll hear from different soloists again. I'm going to get this right. So we have Courtney, we're here on piano, a little bit of Caleb on guitar, all three trumpets, a little bit of trombone. This pretty much features everybody. and a big feature at the end for our percussion section, Luke Wagner, haven't acknowledged, he's been trading off and on with Mitchell here all night. We're going to feature both of them on a last little drum battle on this. So a lot of fun, great composition, great arrangement. Thank you all again so much. This is To God Be the Glory. Thank you. Whitworth Jazz 2. Let them hear it.
Well, good evening. We are grateful you are here with us, either here in person or watching our live stream online. Before we play our next piece, I just want to take a brief moment and thank a few people who have made tonight's performance possible. First of all, we have a handful of folks on stage who have rehearsed with us all semester. They're community members and alumni. They've come back and played with us. They've been here every Monday night, plugging in some parts that otherwise we wouldn't have had. So we are super grateful for our alumni and community members who have joined us this semester for their time and talents that they've donated. Their names are in your program. We also have seven Wind Symphony students playing with us tonight, again, playing crucial parts that we would have been missing this evening. And so can we just give a round of applause for all of our volunteers for helping us out? This next piece I picked in large part because our concert falls just 3 days after Veterans Day. It's titled Arlington, subtitled Where Giants Lie Sleeping. And while it might be a more fitting piece for a Memorial Day tribute, I think it's just a beautiful, wonderful reminder of the sacrifice that our servicemen and women make on a daily basis on our behalf. And some of them, of course, many of them over the generations have made the ultimate sacrifice. This piece starts out really as a musical portrait of the Arlington National Cemetery, and it portrays the beauty of the cemetery, but also the weight of it. And you'll hear at the beginning a couple trumpets from offstage, and those represent the bugle calls that are heard every day at Arlington. Later on, the clarinets introduce My Country, 'Tis of Thee, and eventually we wind our way to a hymn called God of Our Fathers, or God of the Ages. Many people call it the national hymn, and that hymn can be heard from time to time in Arlington, played by one of our nation's military bands. The hymn is... it's powerful, but it's also beautiful and celebratory. And I just want to read you the first verse of that hymn. It says, God of the ages, whose almighty hand leads forth in beauty all the starry band of shiny worlds in splendor through the skies, our grateful songs before thy throne arise. So this is Arlington.
Thank you.
Our final selection this evening is actually a brand new piece. It was just published this year. And it's a piece that's also based on a hymn, although one I think that's much lesser known, not as easily recognized. It's titled, "Lo, He Comes on Clouds Descending." And the text of this hymn actually refers to the glory, the moment of glory when someone enters heaven. And the third verse references Jesus, and it says, "With what rapture gaze we on those glorious scars." So this piece really attempts to portray moments of that glory and awe and rapture, but also the composer really intended to include moments of intense reflection and grace. So we leave you tonight with Brian Balmage's Rapture.
Thank you.
Thank you.